ഐ ആം ബിനോയ് ജോസഫ്, സിൽവർ ഹിൽസ് ഹയർ സെക്കൻഡറി സ്കൂളിലെ ഫാക്കൽറ്റിയാണ്. ഇന്ന് ഹിസ്റ്ററിയിലെ ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഫോക്കസ് ഏരിയയിലെ ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് എക്സ്പ്ലോയിറ്റേഷൻ ആൻഡ് റെസിസ്റ്റൻസ് എന്ന പാഠഭാഗത്തിലെ ഫോക്കസ് ഏരിയ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. ഇതിൽ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഈ ഫോക്കസ് ഏരിയയുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുകൊണ്ട് വരാൻ പറ്റുന്ന ഒരു ചോദ്യമാണ് ഇമ്പാക്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് പോളിസീസ്. ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് പോളിസി കൊണ്ട് എന്തെല്ലാം ഇമ്പാക്റ്റ് ആണ് ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുള്ളത്. ദർ ആർ ടു ഇമ്പാക്ട്സ് ആക്ച്വലി ഹാപ്പൻ. വൺ ഈസ് ഫോർ ഫാമേഴ്സ് വർ ദ ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ് വിക്ടിംസ്. ദർ വർ ദ ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ് വിക്ടിംസ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് ലാൻഡ് റവന്യൂ പോളിസീസ്. ദൻ ദ ലാൻഡ് റവന്യൂ പോളിസീസ് ഡിസ്ട്രോയ്ഡ് ദം, ദി ഫാമേഴ്സ്. ആൻഡ് increased by these atrocities and exploitation, the maximum profit being earned by the British. That was the impact, the sudden impact of British colonization. Now when we are talking about how they've been implemented, these things how been implemented by using three important measures in different parts of India, that is different land revenue policies of British. First one is the permanent settlement that happened in Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. The second one, it's in Roythwari system in the South Indian regions. And the Mahalwari system, it's in the Northwest regions. These are the three important land revenue policies adopted by the British to get maximum money from India. We can call it as revenue. Then the first one is permanent settlement, that is also called as zamindari system. The tax was collected by zamindars. That's the one, the owner of this all is zamindar. Zamindar was the owner of the land. He was the owner of the land. He had the power to collect tax. Farmers became the tenants of zamindar. They had to pay around 60% of their yield to these zamindars, even the time of poor harvesting. This was an atrocity, or even what we called it as a troublesome period for the farmers in zamindari system. Now the second one is the Roythwari system. What are the important features of Roythwari system? Tax was collected directly from farmers, that is Royths, by the company itself. The company itself collect the amount from the farmers. Farmers were the owners of the land. There is a difference between zamindari and this one, Roythwari, where in zamindari the ownership been in zamindars, but here the ownership been there in the tenant's hand itself. Excessive tax was imposed and tax was frequently increased by the company. Now the third one is what we called it as the Mahalwari system. The Mahalwari system. Tax was collected by the village headman. The first, in the zamindari system, zamindar was the head. The second one, the company itself collecting the thing. Here we can see the village headman. Excessive tax was imposed everywhere, the same thing. And the entire village, that is Mahal, as a unit, they had to pay the tax. Now when we are talking about this in a nutshell, tax collected by permanent settlement zamindar. In Roythwari, company directly. Mahalwari system, village headman. Now when we are talking about the landowners, in the permanent settlement, it's zamindar. In the Roythwari, the farmers itself. And the same thing happened in the Mahalwari, the landlord. Now the same, the tax burden, they had to pay more, and if it is a least harvest period also, they had to pay higher taxes. This is all about the taxation. Now it's been having a big problem to the common people. They have been highly taxed and they've been given high amount of interest. If they are not payable, they had to give their land to the landlords, or even they've been evicted. This was the situation at that time. Now, the second important focus point of this chapter is the Kurishia revolt. The Kurishia revolt started in 1812, organized by Kurishias and Kurumbas of Wayanad, Kerala. It's led by Raman Nambi. And what are the important reasons? The same thing itself: excessive taxes, tax cash. Now, till that period, the tenants, that is the traditional Adivasis, had to give their taxes not in kind, they had to give in cash. They are not having the cash itself, but they have been forcefully given the opportunity of giving the tax as cash. And it created a lot of problems. And if they are not able to give the tax, their agricultural lands been seized, and even they've been evicted from the forest. This is all about Kurishia revolt, and the people revolted against these things. Now, the third point in this chapter, the British exploitation, final point of the focus area is 1857 revolt. 1857 revolt, we already studied about. It started, it's also called it as the First War of Independence. First War of Independence. Now, what led to the riot? What are the important points? It can be broadly classified into four. One, we called it as the economic cause. Second one, we called it as the political cause. Third one, we can call it as the religious cause. And even we can call it as what we called it as the political, religious, military, and economical cause. Now, what is economical cause? Misery of the farmers and the craftsmen. And the militia, called as sepoys, as lower salary. And the religious cause, they had to use cartridges which have been made by some pig's meat or a pig's fat. And even for the Hindus, they are having a sacred thing about cow. They had to use that cartridge which has been greased by cow's fat. This is the immediate cause of 1857 revolt. And the political cause, we studied in the previous class about doctrine of lapse. If they are not having a proper legal heir, after they are joining into this doctrine of lapse, the country being belonging to the British, that we call it as the doctrine of lapse. These are the three focus area for this chapter, what we called it as the British exploitation.